Aysha, only on LA Talk Radio.
Good morning. Wow, we have a room full of some incredibly talented artists here. Vocalists, musicians, what a way to start the day.
This is great.
And we have somebody that is from, what did they say, across the pond?
It's a big pond.
It's a big pond. Welcome to Smooth Saturdays with Aysha. My name is Aysha. I'm your host. I'm my co-host, Mikey Adam Cohen.
Hello, everybody. It's nice to be here, and I'm happy to be with everybody that's here tonight, today.
Are you still asleep?
Yes, I'm still asleep.
I'm gonna. You're talking into the wrong side of the mic there.
Okay, there you go.
Now much better. Now we can hear you.
Very nice. Always.
It's great to see everybody. We got guitarist Terry Wolllman in the house.
Yeah. Good morning, Aysha.
Good morning.
Hi, everybody.
We have keyboardist, producer, good friend of mine, and Terry, you're a good friend of mine too. I didn't mean to eliminate that.
No, not at all.
I haven't seen Ollie Silk, everyone.
Ollie.
Yes. Thank you. Great to be here.
I haven't seen him since February of 2013 when we went to Dubai.
Wow.
We had a blast.
We had so much fun.
I miss it.
That was such a blast.
Yeah.
And singing diva Shannon Pearson. You're a good
friend of mine. Yes, and she's going to be singing with Ollie because she's on the album, right?
Yeah, she's on the All We Need album. Yeah.
So I can't wait. We've had Shannon on before, and we've had Terry on before, and it's your first time. You're a virgin.
I'm nervous. Very. Everyone's watching me.
It'll go over very slow.
Well, I'm gonna play "Take Me Higher" just to kind of break the ice and let you guys just exhale since you're nervous.
Get a little bit of you.
And then we'll get into an interview. We're going to start with you, Terry, when we come back.
Okay.
Sound good?
No pressure.
Sounds great.
All right. We'll be back.
You're listening to Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio.
Higher, step on in, this is where it all begins, to take you higher, oh, I want
take you higher.
Take me higher, take me higher.
Giving it all for me, trying to turn my life around.
Turn my life around. Take me higher,
take you back. Show me how to step on up so I can reach that higher.
If you just tuned in, you're listening to Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio. And I'm going to get right into it, Terry.
Let's do it.
I'm going to get
You brought some goodies. I brought
us.
Show and tell because we're going a little retro because I wanted to dig into the vaults. And I thought, well, why don't we go back to my first record?
Isn't this your new one?
Well, that's what Ollie was saying. Is this your new
record
with a very cool
dude
retro?
Here. Wow. Check out this hot.
Who is that?
Who is this?
Right. That's who I used to be. That's
Now, if I remember, this picture was posted, well, it was plastered at Tower Records.
It was on Sunset Boulevard.
In a giant form?
They did a huge piece of art around this album. They actually used the flat, you know, the cover of the record. And then built up this whole thing, and they had it up in that store for about 8 months, which was incredible because normally the record labels would buy the space, and you would get it for 4 weeks. But my record label at the time would not buy the space, but I became friends with the manager of the store. She loved the album and loved that I was a new artist, you know, on the radio. And
I think she just thought you were good looking.
Yeah, I know. I think it's just
the photo didn't hurt.
Yeah. Look at the muscles.
That perhaps that might be part of the story. But they kept it. I think because they made it. The coolest thing was they've never had done that for another artist. The store actually did it themselves. So it was their piece of art, and they kept it up in the store. And then they called me and said, "We're finally taking this down. Do you want it?" So it's up in the wall of my house.
Oh my gosh.
And it's signed, you know, Tower Records,
yes,
1988.
I've seen it. You showed that to me.
Right.
Yeah.
It's a very cool piece of history. So that's my Bimini record.
I just have one question.
Yes.
That front cover? Asleep or awake?
Totally awake. Yeah. Totally awake.
Yeah. Yeah.
He was smiling here.
I was.
He's got a nice grin on his face. What were you thinking about?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I was just, you know, my friend Lenny Iger took the picture. He used to work. He did platinum prints and an amazing artist. I've known him for most of my life, and I flew up to Northern California. He said he would do the artwork, you know, for my first record, and he just took me to a couple locations. So this was in Northern California, and it was some little outside some hardware store, this cool wall that he loved, and just leaning against the wall, getting some sun, and closing my eyes, and
nice.
Just feeling the sun and relaxing. And that was the photo that got chosen by the art department. It's not one that I would have initially chosen because I was used to just seeing pictures of myself smiling and playing and, you know, and looking
more the performance type of picture.
Yeah, but everybody went for that and they talked me into it and I'm glad it turned out to be a really strong piece of art. You know,
where did the title come from?
Bimini. I grew up in Miami, and so I have tropical roots.
Okay.
And Bimini is the closest island to Miami from in the Bahamas.
Oh.
It's a very small island.
Okay.
And it's the first one that you hit when you're sailing to the Bahamas. Mm-hmm. So it's
then
a cool
island. Then I've sailed, I went to the Bahamas via Fort Lauderdale.
Yeah, so you would have sailed by it.
Okay.
As a matter of fact, on a clear day, which is most days in Miami, which are most days, if you're looking to the east, you can see these clouds. And basically, the cloud formation is over the islands. And that's how you know where the island is.
Oh, okay.
If you're heading towards it, if that's your destination, you go towards the clouds.
I never noticed the little picture here in the back.
Yeah, explain that one.
What is it? I can't see from here.
You need your glasses?
No. It's just, no, there's three microphones between me and the photo. Well, I think that was the compromise. I wanted one of me looking into the camera smiling, so that was
I
more
never
how
noticed that when I've seen this album cover
yeah,
before.
I like it.
That
I
was
like
more
it.
How I was used to seeing myself. So they
I know
say,
you
well,
guys can't see this. We don't have a yeah. Zoom on our on
well,
our camera,
we're also on the radio, so.
No, this is TV.
Yeah, well, it's both. Yeah. Yes. Well, I know we're on TV, and that's why I brought some visual aids, some show and tell.
This is awesome.
Yeah, so that's my first record.
So I'm going to play a song that you sent me called Cancun.
Yeah.
Tell us about this, and what album was this from?
That's from my Say Yes record. I had gone with some friends that I grew up with in Miami. They were taking their boat to Mexico across the Gulf. And they said, you should really come one of these times when we're out there. So I found a spot of time, and these are really dear friends of mine. We all grew up together. And so I flew out there, and I stayed on the boat with them in Cancun. And this is what I thought of Cancun. I expressed it through this
cool.
piece of music.
And which album number is this? Because you have 25 years, right, of,
I sure
of
do.
Recording.
Yeah.
So, and how many albums?
I think I have 6 albums. I always have to look at my website or 7. I forget.
I can't remember.
Ollie, do you have any idea? Yeah, no.
I think it's 6.5.
Yeah, 6.5. I think, and I believe this was my second record.
Okay, and it was called, the record was called again?
Record's called Say Yes.
Say Yes. So we're kind of going back and then coming to the present with his music. So if you hear stuff that you like, you have this all available. Is it still available for sale?
Oh, yeah. It's up on iTunes and CD Baby. And you can also, you could probably hear some of the songs on YouTube as well as Spotify and all of those. But everything.
So if they hear something they like, they can buy it then,
absolutely.
Right?
You can buy this song.
It's not out of production anymore.
This one is not.
Perfect.
And just, you can always go to terrywolman.com, and that's going to send you links to everywhere. And that website, our website is always changing every day. There's something new on it.
There sure is.
Oh, nice.
Like, there might even be a picture of Shannon and Ollie and I by the end of today, if we get this right. Here we go. So it might be up there by the end of this song, is, you know, because the technology is so deep.
All right, well, let's check this out. This is Cancun by our in-studio guest, Terry Wolman, right here on Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio.
And I wanted to add, in honor of Cancun Jazz Festival, we have your song playing with a slideshow of all the great moments.
Oh, that's perfect. Thank you.
Wonderful. I like the energy already on this.
Yeah.
Great song.
Thank you, Mikey. Yeah. So this, you know, a lot of you who have seen me travel around the world with my Taylor acoustic guitar, this was the first song that I played it on. They sent me this guitar for this record, for the Say Yes record.
Oh, nice.
So we go way, way back. So that's a little piece of artist trivia.
Yeah, I like it.
Yeah, yeah. And that's Abraham Laboriel on the bass. John Robinson on the drums, JR, Luis Conte on percussion, and Mark Hugenberger on keyboards, and then me on electric acoustic guitars. And
yes, oh, you're playing on this?
A little bit, a little bit. I always try to play something on my record. Just keep me in the loop.
Thanks for introducing me to JR.
Oh, yeah.
Graham, that day.
So here's that Taylor guitar, the first solo I ever played on it.
You're breaking it in right here.
That's right. Bringing Shannon to all my radio shows.
Sizzling.
This was the first record that I did with JR. Yeah. And we had a ball.
Nice.
He blew me away.
I believe he was one of the musicians that played on my EP. The songs were recorded before I got them.
I believe that's right. I remember reading that credit.
Yes.
Yes. I think you can tell I really like going to Cancun.
Well, I think you deserve to be at the Cancun Jazz Festival this next year.
Yeah, let's
both
do
of
it.
You, both of you.
Yeah, that would be great. Yeah. I haven't been to Cancun.
That's
been
beautiful.
To Puerto Vallarta, Cabo.
Talk to Warren, see if we can make that happen.
Yes.
So I really love using space in my records. You know, with these remarkable musicians that can play anything, I love that we all still don't overplay.
Right.
You know, everybody's listening to each other and having this musical dance together.
It's nice because you can hear the separation. You can hear the different instruments. When sometimes it's just so much, you can't really make out what's what.
I really give a lot of thought and time to mixing my records so that there's a clarity.
Right. So off of this album, we're going to fade, put it down in the background.
Mm-hmm.
Out of this album, what's your favorite song? Give me your favorite song to play?
Well, you know, this is definitely one of my favorites, and the reason that I chose this is because I've been thinking about dusting this one off and starting to play it with the band because I haven't played it for years.
Oh, okay.
And it's a really fun song to play. I mean, it's fun to hang and listen to it with my friends and all of you out there. I want to start playing it again.
Good.
Yeah, so, this might be my current favorite from... the Say Yes record.
Brings back probably a lot of good memories, I'm sure.
It does. Yeah. It really does. And by the way, my buddy Ollie Silk and I, we just were on the Dave Koz cruise together.
Oh, nice.
So it's really nice to see you again so quickly.
That was fun.
Yeah, we had a great time together.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah,
we spent some nights in the pub, didn't we?
We did.
Yeah,
we were in the pub a little bit. we had a few toast.
Yes.
And we played some music together,
too,
which is
great.
Really fun. Yeah.
Very, very cool. One of these days I want to make it on that, too.
Yeah, we have a great time.
We need you there.
Yeah, you know, Mikey and Jack were there. We had a just phenomenal time.
Didn't see much of you, Mikey.
I know. I saw you with Spencer and Ariana.
Oh, yeah.
How nice.
Yeah. So that was Cancun.
So moving forward, okay, after Cancun, after the
Say
the
Yes,
after this that album happened,
mm-hmm.
How long? So you've done 25 years of music,
right?
You have 6 or 7. You don't know how many albums.
We can get our Google out.
So it sounds like you got quite a bit of time on each album. That they had a lot of leg legs to it where they lasted for a while.
They actually did.
You know, your next one.
Yeah, well, the Bimini record, part of the reason I brought it, besides that it was fun to find the actual LP and share it with you on camera.
Does anybody make LPs anymore?
Yeah.
They're coming back. They're making a resurgence.
I would love to do something on vinyl.
And they sound great.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they really do.
They have the real... true sound.
Yeah.
You know. There were 10 years between this first record and the Say Yes record, the one that you just heard.
10 years.
Yeah. And, you know, one of the things that happened with my first album, which is kind of not typical, is that there were 8 songs on the record and all 8 songs ended up on the radio.
That's what I was saying. They had a lot of legs to it.
It really had a life.
So you didn't have to get back in the studio right away and record because you were still... working off of this one.
Yeah. Yeah. It was getting, that was back in the day when DJs would play what they liked. And different stations around the country and around the world, they all logged on to about, or held on to about 2 or 3 songs that, and it was fascinating to me to see who liked what, depending on which part of the country. Yeah. But they were rotating 2 or 3 songs at a time. And ironically, and shockingly, the very first song that got played on the radio that I heard in L.A. was this song, Reflections, which is a ballad that's 8 minutes long.
Wow.
And
what? And they played the whole thing?
They played the whole thing on the radio.
That's incredible.
Ka-ching!
Yeah. Right. I was going to get into how emotional that was for me, but I just nailed it.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Yeah. Additionally, ka-ching. Yeah. It was the song that I just did not want to do a radio edit because everybody had played so beautifully, and I just thought, that one's not going to get radio play, but hopefully the others will. But
and
that was,
it did.
It was the first.
So that was like your Bohemian Rhapsody, right?
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah.
Well, I have to say kudos to you for putting out an album back then that had so many great songs on it because
thank you.
We talked about this on the last show, how, you know, before people would just put out these albums and there would be one good song on it. And you could not buy them.
Right.
You couldn't download a single like you can today.
Yeah.
And so you'd buy the album and there'd be only one song that was any good. And it was just, it was horrible.
Disappointing.
Very, you know, you're spending all this money for one song. Mm-hmm.
Well, my goal was to make the best record that I could. It was my first record. But also to make a record that people would enjoy. You know, and that was a pet peeve of mine. You know, you go spend your $7.99 for an album, and you only like one song, and
that was it.
It was kind of disappointing. You know,
basically, a coaster.
That's right. Well, actually, you're too young to remember this, but instead of coasters, which the CDs are now, these were used. I grew up in Miami, so I was exposed to a lot of drugs. Even though I didn't take them, I was around them.
We won't say anything.
Well, I just didn't. But the thing is, these were used for rolling, you know, you'd put your pot and then you'd get your rolling paper. So that's what the albums were used for, you know, back in the 70s.
Wow.
You know, and then you'd flip them over and then read the credits.
Oh, wow. You know? That's so funny. After you got high, you could read the credits.
That's right.
Yeah. Oh, that's funny.
So they were kind of one stop for entertainment.
That's funny.
Yeah, so I grew up watching all my friends just, you know, rolling their joints, you know, on records. And again, hoping that there was more than one song in the record that you would like.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, that's my Miami roots.
So let's talk about this one that made it on, it's called I'll Be the One.
Yeah.
And it was on a soundtrack for a show for...
For Dawson's Creek,
the
TV
really?
Show. Yeah, they somehow they heard this because this is a song that I haven't released on a record and it's not on iTunes. But one of the music producers had heard it, and I got a call from Sony Music asking if they could license it for the show.
Oh.
So we, of course, agreed. And I thought it'd be fun. You know, one of the things people forget about me is I write pop tunes as well, you know, and vocal tunes and work with singers and like yourself. And this was one that I did with a great singer named Kat Adams. She sang. She was kind enough to come grace her voice.
Right, and I'm trying to find it. Here we go. Ah. Here we go.
So this is an acoustic version that I did with in my studio with mandolin and acoustic guitars, and I played bass on it, and just wanted to keep it really simple. And I wouldn't say this was the demo, but this was like just a real homegrown recording that I didn't expect to end up on a TV show, but I certainly put all my heart and attention.
So what I'm going to do, because you have an R&B version of this.
Yeah.
So I'm going to play a little bit of this
Perfect.
One.
Perfect. Yeah.
And then I'm going to play some of the R&B one.
Yeah.
It's just interesting how completely, yeah. The
oh, yeah. It's really amazing. And it was a lot of fun to take a different approach with it, because I always, you know, I always thought it would be a very cool, like, boys to men kind of a tune, you know, at the time, or, you know, another group like that. So here's... Thank you. Both versions.
Yeah. So we're going to do the Cat Adams one first. And this is the one that was on Dawson's Creek.
Yes,
right?
It is.
All right. Let's check this out. You're listening to Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio. And this is our guest, Terry Wolllman, with his song, the Dawson's Creek version of
I'll Be the One.
I'll Be
there
the One.
You go.
Great idea to play both. I like this a lot.
You want to kind of hear the contrast,
and the
right?
versatility. Yeah.
There comes a time when your heart knows love has a brand new meaning. Inside your eyes I find myself lost in this urgent feeling. Holding you closer, scared of
I was that romantic.
That's
gonna make me cry.
I know. Me too.
This is really pretty.
I was thinking of you, Ollie, when I wrote that. So crazy.
So is this the actual version that plays on the show?
Yeah, this was, which made me really happy, because when you do something just for the sake of the music, and then it ends up on TV, it's cool, and as you had said, ka-ching.
Ka-ching. All right.
So that's where this came from. This was the writer's version of it, and then we went and produced this very different version that I equally love.
This could be my new anthem. I like this. Okay. Yeah, seriously.
All right. Well, let's check out the R&B side of
this.
So the R&B one is, who's singing on that one?
Wes Crave.
Wes Crave.
Yeah. And he's a L.A. singer. And this was produced by my friend Kevin Cloud, who's a drummer with me on the Byron Allen Show and the Late Show on Fox.
Oh, wow.
It's different.
Yeah.
Inside your eyes I find myself lost in the surging feeling, holding closer.
Good description, voice command. I like that.
I hear the voice to men part that you're talking about with the harmonies.
I will be whenever you
the boy
need
band.
Me.
Nice.
I'll always be just around.
Yeah.
I will catch you when you're falling. I'll never let you go.
I like the boy version of my anthem.
So this was a really fun way to record the song, because I envisioned it this way as well. This one's still up for grabs. Yeah, it hasn't been recorded yet, but this has never been released.
Oh,
That's why I thought it'd be fun to share with
everyone.
You.
This is a first, everyone.
This is the first time
heard
this is on the radio.
Good day. It's a great record. You kiss
my this is awesome. Come on, so revealing two words that's spoken.
Do you hear the men? Your heart. I'm just not going to try to sing it. I feel like
everybody.
I will love you. I will hold you till the end of time. I will be here whenever you need me.
Who could you see singing this now in today's artist?
Definitely Justin Timberlake. Slay this. Bruno Mars would wipe the floor with us too because he's such a great singer. Who else?
Javier Colon.
Javier. Oh,
I can totally see Javier Colon.
Yeah. You know, that's so interesting. Kevin Cloud was the person who produced Javier's first record that I played on. That's how I met Javier. With Sir Kevin. So that would be a complete circle. Key change?
Why not?
Maybe you should reach out to Javier.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're friends.
But maybe you should.
Yeah, I'd love to sing.
That would be.
Yeah.
So you heard it here. Yeah. The song is up for grabs, but maybe not for long.
Yeah, radio debut. You've broken other songs of mine, as a matter of fact.
Oh, well, yeah. Well, you sent me Survive.
I think we broke Mandela on your show, or Buddha's Ear. It was one of my singles we broke on your show.
Oh,
you got it first.
Nice, nice. Well, I know that you sent me Survive first as well.
Well, it's kind of, you're my lucky charm, I think.
We start with you. Thank you. Smooth Saturdays with Aysha, thanks you.
Yeah.
I mean, I love doing what we do because we get to meet some just incredibly talented people. And then I get to have my friends on that I've known that, that I just love what you do and just look up to you and appreciate what you do.
Thank you.
So it's nice to keep the music alive and show my appreciation for what you guys do and share it with everybody. So I'm always happy to.
You met Terry through your show, right?
Well, you introduced me to Terry. Yeah, yeah, we sat out in the marina one day and just had a nice long talk.
Yeah.
And we just.
You clicked.
Clicked.
Yeah, we went and had a coffee, and I don't drink coffee, so I had a tea. I didn't want to like complicate the, well, let's meet for coffee. I can't do that. But I that was a wonderful meeting. That was we ended up
talking for a long time.
Yeah. It was great. I just went, okay, this feels good. I've got a new friend.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And you've become a very good friend, both me and Dion, you know, and UML. So
yeah.
Very, very nice.
Thank you, Mikey, for that introduction. That was a good call. So again, this was produced by my friend Kevin Cloud, who introduced me to Javier. He discovered Hoff from Connecticut.
So this was like, it just totally makes sense.
20 years ago or whenever we did, and I played on Javier's first record. And Kevin and I have a long friendship. We met when I was music directing my first late night talk show, the Late Show on Fox, and he was the drummer with Jack Mack and the Heart Attack. That was the band, and I was the music director.
I remember that group.
Yeah, so I was the music director for the show, and then we did that for a year. And then that's when this record came out, 1988. It was my first TV show, and I was on the radio, and I was on TV and working my tail off and going to the gym every morning at 6 in the morning before. And you
that's
know,
why
and
he looked like this.
Right, again, like when when I just had time to practice guitar and write songs and go to the gym. Yeah, no relationships or anything, right? And then when I got hired to music direct the Byron Allen Show and put my own band together, or bring my band, Byron actually asked, he requested Kevin as the drummer. He said, what about that drummer that was on that last TV show that you did? And I said, he's great. I love him. So I brought him along with me. And And we did that show for 3 years as well. So it was, you know, yeah, we made a lot of music together.
Nice, nice. Well, let's talk about this next one, The Miracle.
Well, yeah, I think this is more of my R&B pop roots. This is it sticks its big toe in gospel on this song as well. But I wrote this song with two other co-writers, Lilouette Fox, who's a Canadian songwriter, and this I believe this was the first song she and I wrote, and we had gotten it to where it was, I thought, really good, but it wasn't great yet. There was one or two lines that just could have been more, and I couldn't quite figure it out, and she was pretty happy with it. And I said, you know, we can bring this from great to amazing if we bring in another co-writer, and it was Brenda Lee Yeager, who also sang. She's a great writer. She's had songs covered by Prince and other folks, and so I said she could sing it for us, and she's a great writer. So we brought her in. She heard the song, loved it. We tightened it up. We did a demo with me playing piano and Brenda singing, and then we tracked some background vocals. And they had asked me, my co-writers had said, well, now that this sounds, you know, so great, I couldn't find the original demo. I would have brought it. That would have been fun. But they said, why don't you add guitar? You know, and I said, yeah, if I add guitar, then I need to add bass and drums, and then it's a thing. And I just want to leave it alone. I think just piano and the voices, especially with all the background vocals that we did in the choruses, I said, I think the song speaks for itself. And it did. It ended up getting covered by Cliff Richard. This is the version that I brought, who's a major British talent. Ollie, of course, you grew up on Cliff Richard, I would imagine. Not so much.
Maybe not. But maybe not. I mean,
but he's an icon. He was like, he's your Elvis.
Yeah.
No? I mean, because he's also a film star and been making records since
Back then he was a film star.
Then. Now he's an old guy, right?
Right. Well, yeah, I mean, he started in 1952.
Right,
Way back then.
So
did he really?
Yeah, he did. Yeah. So he's, as a matter of fact,
he had a number one record in every decade up to, the teens is the only decade he hasn't done it. But yeah, 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, 90s, noughties. Yes. He had a number one.
That's so like this very, ended up crazy. This ended up in the Billboard Top 10 in the UK as a single for him.
Yeah, I know the song. Yeah,
you
yeah.
do.
Yeah,
oh, that's great. And then it ended up on his greatest hits record, which was like a double thrill for all of us.
Isn't that another cha-ching?
Yes. Yeah.
And let me hold a dollar. All these cha-chings around here.
Yeah. Terry's buying the beer.
I need to rub your shoulder and get some of that mojo.
But here's the coolest thing. So it got covered, and I had nothing to do with the arrangement or the production. Once it went out to the universe, they had their own people record it and everything. And they ended up doing the whole, not only the first verse, but the first chorus stayed like true to the original demo. The rhythm section doesn't come in until the second verse.
Nice.
So they actually followed the essence of what we put down in in my bedroom studio at the time. So this is Cliff Richard singing The Miracle.
Let's hear it.
You're listening to Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio with our in-studio guest Terry Wolllman sharing his music right here.
Destruction. Can't believe we do what we do. Let's take the world in a new direction. Let every step move us closer to that miracle that's gonna spread the good news.
Here's where the band would usually come in.
Love is the key that opens up a new way. Love is the answer we've been searching for. Open your heart if you're looking for a miracle. A miracle is love. Everybody wants to win the wheel of fortune. Say they'll be happy. Well, they do.
What year did this come out?
Looking for the temple salvation. Every step
that's 15 years ago.
Like early 2000s, maybe. Yeah, like maybe 2000. Yeah.
Did you ever put this on any of your albums?
No. Yeah. I'm going to do a version of this.
Share song.
Yeah, I do too. Actually, Tina Turner for me. I'd love to hear Tina sing this.
Open your heart. Open your heart. It's a miracle. A miracle. Love is the key. It's the key. It opens a new way. Love is the answer. We've been searching for it. Open your heart. Gotta be looking for a miracle.
Miracle is love. Thank you.
Very cool.
Yeah,
you're listening to Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio. That was The Miracle. Cliff Richard did this song.
Yeah, that was my first pop hit. And it was a thrill. Especially, you know, you get the CD in the mail and I put it on and I listened and I was just beside myself. I couldn't believe that they didn't bring the band in until the
great.
Yeah, the second verse. I mean, it was just that was such a unique experience for me. And of course, hearing a full production, you never know,
right?
You know,
what's going to come out like.
Yeah, you know, it can be disappointing sometimes, but right. There was nothing disappointing about this. I just was in tears. You know, it was so exciting to me to hear somebody else breathe their life into,
and of that caliber too.
Yeah. But so yeah, and then I saw there's a DVD that came across of them singing, performing at Royal Albert Hall.
Okay.
Of this song, so I got to see that as well.
Oh, nice. Nice.
Yeah.
Well, I want to do one more song before you play live.
Sure.
And the song is called "Can You Feel It?"
Ah, so this is another side of me as well. I was. This is from a record. Called Can You Dance? And I was asked to put a group together, and we called it Baila. That was the name of the group. And it was a dance record. You know, I was asked to write and produce a dance record, and I put a really fun band together with Jonathan Sugarfoot Moffitt on drums,
yeah. Uh-huh.
Who had done the last year of the Byron Allen Show with me, but a lot of people know him from Madonna and Michael Jackson. So Sugarfoot, Vale Johnson on bass, who, from Kenny G's band, who's just a monster bass player. And he and I had been in other bands together. I thought it'd be fun to bring him in. Mark Hugenberger again on keyboards, myself on electric guitars. No, I don't think there's an acoustic guitar on this record, as a matter of fact. And then the singers were Amy Keys. Well, Amy was the lead singer for the group, and then we also brought in Ellis Hall to sing in the group.
Nice.
And
nice.
Yeah, and Kat Adams and Donna McAfee were the three backup singers, you know, the ensemble we put together. But the core band was with Amy singing, who a lot of people know
her
through Phil Collins and Toto, and she and I've written, as a matter of fact, we wrote A Little More Love another song of mine that I think I've played for you before.
I think you have.
So, but this was the executive producer of the record at the time. Techno was really getting pretty big, and he actually brought me to some techno raves in Northern California. And
so that inspired this?
Well, you know, the funny thing was, you know, he said, I really need you to understand this style. And, you know, and we bought some gear that so I could get those sounds and program and things like that. And I started writing, and then he actually even bought me a disco light and a to inspire me in my studio, you know, so that it was like this, you know, relentless flashing of
lights to
make me like want to go crazy. Yeah.
Well, let's check it out.
Yeah. So anyway, this was one of the songs that we wrote, and
this is Can You Feel It?
Can You Feel It? It was a lot of fun, and I wrote a little string quartet break in the middle too.
Okay, you can. Mikey loves this stuff.
I do too. It's really fun.
Don't give away my secrets. This is a smooth jazz show.
It's all music.
Everybody dance.
Everybody dance. So when I started writing for this record, I played some of my tracks for the executive producer, and he said, you know something? It's too techno. I went too far. He created a monster. So I gave him back the light, the disco light, and went a little bit back to club dance with some techno influence.
I like this.
Thanks.
This is fun.
I had a great time making this record. They're fun songs to write also.
Shannon's very informative.
Yeah, she is. She is.
So I thought instead of a guitar solo, which is expected, I would do a string quartet and then go into a guitar solo. So that's what's coming up.
Oh, I love it.
Now the guitar.
Nice. Why don't you grab your guitar if you're right. Playing next.
Yep.
Speaking of guitars. Having way too much fun.
Kind of reminds me of Taylor Dane, that.
Yeah. Yeah. She can sing.
She does have kind of that.
Taylor Dane kind of vibe, yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Is that how it looks?
Are you available for my next record?
Just with that growl.
I'll hold a spot for you.
I'm very just busy, man. I
just got very, very busy, right?
So you get to choose which one you want to play first, because you brought me two.
Yeah.
So are we going to do Welcome to Paradise or Getting Ready to Get Ready?
Let's do, let's start with Getting Ready to Get Ready.
That's what I put it in.
Okay. See, I knew, huh? Great minds.
All right. Live for you, we got Terry Wolllman playing a little something, something. Now, is this a new song, or what is this from?
It's from my Buddha's Ear record.
It is?
Yeah.
Okay. You've never played this one for us, though.
No, I don't think
okay.
I have.
All right.
Yeah, it's a fun tune. I like playing it. It was a fun one to write. And just so you know, Getting Ready to Get Ready is, we all know what it's like when, you know, you're running out the door and you got to be someplace and you're ready, but maybe somebody that you're working with or
isn't quite ready. So they're getting ready.
So I call that getting ready to get ready. come on.
Well, let's check it out. This is Getting Ready to Get Ready.
That's right.
Live for you by Terry Wolllman, right here on Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio. Thank you. Nice, nice, nice. Yes. Getting
Thank
ready
you.
To get ready live.
Yeah, that's fun. Yeah, definitely got an island flavor.
Yes.
That's just what happens when I'm left to my own devices. So
yeah, because several songs that you do have that kind of little island groove, and I love it.
Yeah, I just was exposed to a lot of world music as a kid. I didn't realize it, you know, because I thought I was growing up on R&B, you know, listening to Otis Redding, and
this is what comes out of you.
Yeah.
So you're doing you.
I'm doing me. Yeah, when I'm left to my own devices, this is what you hear.
Okay, so this next song that you're gonna do is one that it's on your first album.
Yeah, it is. And actually, and Ollie, you want to join me on this one?
What key is it in, Terry?
C.
Okay.
Do you know that key?
It's the one right after B, right?
That's right. I have a capo, and it's been a long time. We played this in London at Pizza Express together when I had 3 nights there.
And, nice.
And Ollie was in my band. We had a great time. But this is from my first record. It was the very first track number one mm-hmm. on the very first record. And I thought when I did my Silver Collection record, I wanted to go back and revisit a song, and not because I felt like I had done anything I wanted to change, because there's not a note on this first record that I would change. I mean, I just got it right. You know, everything mm-hmm. like aligned. And but I still thought it'd be fun to go back 25 years later and revisit a song. So I took this one and slowed it down a little bit because, you know, 25 years later, we're a little slower.
We're a little slower.
We're a little wiser.
We hate to admit it, but we're a little slower.
and I brought John Robinson, Abe Laboriel, Greg Manning, Luis Conte, and Dave Koz to play on this song. And it ended up being, it's a single on my record, and it's been getting a lot of radio play. I'd like to play it for you now.
All right,
we're
let's check
some,
it out.
Yeah, a little live piano. It's Jump in anytime.
Welcome to Paradise. Always love this song.
Take it, Ollie.
Here we go.
That's so funny because I thought, hold on a minute, I have my iPad here and it might have, because like
it's been
the
on gig, there?
The show we did at Pizza Express, it was the first time I ever used my iPad for my charts.
So it's on there from last year?
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
Nice.
Wow.
Nice, nice.
And I wanted to say that the keyboard you were playing on belonged to Terry.
That's my old
that's
piano.
Your old yeah. Keyboard.
Yeah, there's some juju on there. Yeah. Some of these songs were written on this.
Very nice.
Yeah.
It's a little messy. Like a you could have cleaned it for them.
I could have.
He wanted to leave the juju on there.
Oh, it's there.
That's right. It's like, yeah, those guys that don't change their strings for 20 years because it's their lucky strings. They have to get a tetanus shot every year before they play.
Terry, thank you so much for coming back on the show and coming
so nice to,
our,
to
new,
be here.
Our new home.
I just, you know, looking outside.
Isn't
and
it beautiful?
It's
beautiful
it's
out today, isn't it?
Really,
oh, my goodness.
It is. Yeah.
But no, thank you so
thank you for having me.
It's always fun to have you on the show.
I appreciate
you know, your
it.
Family.
Yeah,
so you're always, too. You're always, always welcome. So we're going to play a little music and then we're going to come right back to Ollie Silk.
I do want to say, though, on Facebook, Smooth Saturdays with Aysha, you can go and find our archive shows, like our page, and they'll be on
That's
there.
Right. It's smooth it's facebook.com/smoothsaturdayswithaysha. And then, Jack, you were saying the archives are also...
On Facebook, Smooth Saturdays with Aysha.
Okay, so I just said that.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, okay, I thought they were somewhere else, too.
Well, they are going to be on my Facebook and Twitter. I'll start sharing everything as well.
Yes.
So you send me the links.
It's
you can
nice
find them.
Because we're posting the show, the previous shows now, and you can watch them. So if you missed them before, or if you just want to see it again,
just the live performances.
Yeah. So Jack has been great. He's been editing and just putting out the live performance.
It will also
parts
go on our YouTube channel, right? On Jack4951 and our radio station, Smooth Jazz Live 24/7.
So we'll be able to air these all the time, so you can go
Excellent.
Back and listen to it.
Well, we better play good then.
Yes.
right.
Now you tell us.
One
so
chance.
I'm going to try this song for you, Jack, one more time before we get into Ollie. And if it doesn't play, then I'm just tossing it. This is a song off of my new CD that Jack just loves, and I've been trying to play it, and it hasn't been playing on here. I don't know. It features Eric Darius on saxophone, and it's a duet between myself and Monty Stewart, who we co-wrote the song. It's called Undeniable.
Love this song.
You're listening to Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio.
Yay!
Play
it! Yay!
Finally!
And it was worth the wait.
My first impression, I felt your affection. So sweetly caressed me gently, soothing like a melody. How I need this feeling, girl, it keeps me breathing and takes my breath away.
So reliable to me,
the beat brought this love to me,
so you and I can take this ride to.
In your love,
wrapped
for me.
Up in your love.
Oh, how you take me.
Oh, how you take me to a place
that I never wanna leave.
So undeniable to me, the beat has brought this love to be. So you and I can take this ride together.
Scary thing is when the mic's on. I wanna speak to that.
Great writer, great singer, he's incredible.
Take that.
that chance on love this time.
Take that chance.
'Cause what we had is undeniable.
Eric Terry is on sax.
Yeah.
Undeniable.
Ooh. Oh, baby.
You know your love takes me high. You give me love, heart's desires. You give me love through the fire. You give me love, you can't deny. You know your love takes me high.
It takes me high. I love how animated you are. It's great. All right, let's get back to the show.
That was beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you.
I really like that one.
Thank you. Yeah, it was too. A lot of fun. You know, Monty and I have been working together since he helped me record my first demo. Yeah. And I didn't know at the time that he could sing. You know, he was MD for Howard Hewitt. And
I know Monty.
Worked with a lot of people, yeah. And I didn't know he could sing. I mean, I knew he could sing, you know, enough to get by, but he never really sang
in front
of me.
Yeah, there's a lot of folks like that in town, and then they just pretend and they don't know how to sing, and they finally do, and you go, are you kidding me?
Yeah, the years went by, and I'm like, okay, you can sing, and you can sing like that?
Right.
Okay,
Eric
stop.
Eric Valentine.
I was just going to say Eric Valentine can sing.
Yeah.
Really?
He doesn't tell anybody. He can sing.
And
oh,
play guitar.
My goodness.
Yeah,
is that
amazing.
Right?
Oh, my goodness. Yeah.
We give him a mic tonight.
Tonight.
Yes, give him a mic. Give him a mic tonight. Yeah. Do that. Do that. Yeah.
He's not going to get away with
it
now.
So, Ollie, let's get right into you. Tonight you are playing at?
Spaghettini.
In Seal Beach, right?
Yeah, my first time there since 2009.
Nice.
Oh, wow. So you have Eric Valentine on drums.
We have Eric Valentine, that fabulous singer, on drums. We have Adam Holly on guitar. We have Nate Kearney on bass, and we have the beautiful Shannon Pearson on vocals.
Yay. Oh my gosh!
Yeah.
I hope I don't get out of work really really late, because if I can get off on time, I really want
get
to
there.
See the show.
Great. Yeah, we're going. I'll be in the audience.
Oh yeah. My gosh. I'm going to really try and get out of there. I mean, I have no control over it, but if I am out on time,
fingers crossed for you.
I'm going to come.
Just don't do a good job when you go in. they'll let you leave.
No, they won't. I wish they would. You can take the rest of the day out. So, Ollie, welcome. Welcome to Smooth Saturdays with Aysha.
Oh, pleasure. Thank you for having me. It's
so
great.
All is good. Lots changed in your life since I saw you. You got married.
Yeah.
Because you weren't married.
No,
in
that's
Dubai.
Right.
No.
But so we got married like the end of that year, I guess it was 2013. Uh-huh. Yeah. Now I have a little girl.
Wow. Yeah. What's your girl's name?
Amber.
And she is cute.
She's so cute. Yeah.
Oh, well, you have to pull up a picture for me later on. Or
I will.
Yeah, because I gotta see.
Yeah,
gotta
she's see super cute. So daddy's missing her.
I bet. Or hopefully they're watching you.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, I told Eve about it. So she it might be bedtime. I think it's kind of bedtime over there.
Oh, that's right.
So
that's right. You're
it's
about
like 7
8,
p.m.
8 hours different.
Yeah. So it might be baby bedtime. But she doesn't like to sleep very much. So maybe not.
So give the viewers a little bit of background. And because you have done so much. So give them just a little bit of background on you.
Well, I guess I started in music when I was about 12. I did a lot of theater when I was growing up. I did some singing and some dancing too.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I want to see that.
Ain't
side.
Doing that now. <Me too. laughs> So yeah, I kind of did chorus line stuff, dramatic stuff, amateur
really?
Dramatic stuff. But I also played a lot of keyboard on stage. And I was like part of workshops and things. So that kind of got me through till I was about 17. And then And then I went to college and swiftly left college. That wasn't for me. So I did a year there, but at the time I was getting some lessons in a town about 10 miles from me, and they just had a new contemporary music academy just built there, which is still going very strong today. So I got some kind of jazz lessons. I'd never really been taught how to play jazz, so I got kind of half a dozen jazz lessons, and that set me on my path. But at the time, it was very expensive. I just had a cleaning job, you know. I was making the equivalent of like $60 a week or something.
Oh wow!
And so I didn't have much money. So yeah, I kind of got some lessons, and then I taught myself on going from there. And yeah, I always had an interest in studios and production, and so I had a little setup at home. And I had a day job for like 3 or 4 years, or various day jobs, and then I just made the cut. I was working at an aerospace establishment, very famous one in the UK, because I actually live in the home of British Aerospace, which is called Farnborough.
Oh wow!
And that's where everything was developed, like, and all the history is there of flight and stuff like that. So anyway, I worked for them. Doing nothing flying related, just kind of admin stuff. But at the time, I was I'd kind of built up my studio, and I bought my first Mac, and I kind of had that hooked up. And I'm trying to think of the timeline. I was working with a guy who I met in college called Danny Sugar, and we started on an album under the name Sugar and Silk. We were like a duo. He played bass. I played keyboards. And at the time, my brother was actually an artist manager, a pop artist manager, and he had an artist on his books at the time who had a few hits, and she was being produced by a guy called Tony Swain, who had produced lots of British artists like Imagination and Kim Wilde, and some of those guys back in the 80s. But he was a drummer, and he really liked kind of contemporary jazz and stuff like that. So he actually said to my brother, well, you know what? You know, no charge, but I'd love to mix your brother's record, because at the time I was only like 18, so he's like, cool. So that was a great opportunity for us. So we actually had our first record mixed properly by a professional, you know.
Nice.
And then that was the start of it, really. That came out, that got the attention of a London label who put it out in Europe and the UK. We got some radio play in England, and that kind of, yeah, that set us on our way. We kind of started doing shows, and then we did a follow-up record of Sugar and Silk. And things were going pretty cool. You know, that was nice. I mean, we were quite young, as I said. So Danny and I, we kind of blazed a trail for about 3 years. And then he decided he didn't really want to do it anymore. He was a web guy, so he went off and made proper money.
Ka-ching.
Yeah. So he made the sensible move, and I carried on doing it. And the timeline from then was kind of, I was working on a record with a sax player called James Vargas, who had a record out in 2003, I think. And that got the attention of Trippin' Records.
I was just going to ask you, when did you and Les meet?
So that was 2003. A mutual friend had actually sent the record to Les, because Les lives in the UK. And he really liked it. So he said, yeah, okay, I'd like to put it out on Trippin' Records. Well, obviously, we have Paul Harcastle, and we have some other artists at that time. So James signed with him. I was producing it. And then we came over we did Catalina Jazz Festival in 2004. That was the first time I'd been over to the States. And we did some other festivals. We did the Newport Beach Jazz Festival. And then when we got back, James and I parted company. He kind of wanted to do his own thing. I don't know how into the smooth jazz thing he was. But I then had a relationship with Les. So I said to him, you know, how about I do my own record? And he said, sure. So then I cut my first album, which was called So Many Ways, which came out in 2006.
Wow. Yeah. And I think that's when you and I started talking was...
I think it was. Yeah, it was like in the early days.
It was the MySpace days. Yeah. Yes, I remember. I remember. And I remember you coming back out to the States. And
that's right. And I'd kind of not been on the internet for very long at that point. I was quite a late starter. So it was all kind of news to me. Yeah, I know.
Right? Yeah. Yeah. It's crazy how time flies.
MSN Messenger days. I know.
Right. MySpace. So crazy. But yeah. So... It's so cool to see what you've done. And then I was so happy when I got to go to Dubai and you were going to be there. And I don't know how you guys did what you did. I mean, you learned, I don't know how much material.
That was the big one, wasn't it, that year? That, yes. I think that was like 13 shows, I
yes.
think,
yes.
in 13 Yikes. Nights. So it that was, yeah, rehearse every day, show every night, rehearse every
day. It and was, then, it was. I was, think I was in that trailer shows. Every single day.
Oh my gosh, that trailer, yeah. That wasn't built for comfort, was it, that trailer? No.
But you were keeping us laughing.
Yeah, I hope so. I tried, yeah.
Your whole group. I swear my face hurt every time we would get in the van to drive back. My face would be just killing, you know, Mark James and
yeah, mm-hmm. it was fun. Mark Those guys are so cool. Yeah, yeah. We do a lot of shows together in England and stuff. And that Dubai thing was cool. I think it lasted for about 5 years. We don't
wow.
do it anymore.
Wow.
But,
wow.
It was good.
Yeah. It was a whole lot of fun.
That was my experience when I played with those guys too. With it, I just
of course.
Such a
just
great,
you
a great group of guys.
Smiling.
I mean,
because we had Frank and Mark.
Yeah.
And
yeah. Well, same guys. Yeah. Yeah. Same guys. Yeah. They're like brothers, you know. I mean,
oh yeah, I remember Frank. Yeah, he had a bit too much to drink in Dubai, right?
I have a picture time. That where he's leaning on me. Like
we never let him forget that because he never drinks alcohol, and he's a big guy.
And he had a tough time the next morning and day into the evening.
Yeah, because it wasn't the last show. You see, I was like, Frank, you sure you don't want to do it tomorrow night
right.
when we've had the last show? And for some reason, it worked out that was the big
party
night,
the big jam.
It?
Yeah.
And the next day we had the final show, which was the jam. And he didn't come to rehearsal, did he? And then he came onto the stage for the gig.
It was poor guy.
Oh man, it was funny.
He was not feeling too well.
But that was fun, yeah. So who else did we have there? We had Nicholas Cole was there, right?
We had Nicholas Cole. Really? We had Lynn Roundtree. Wow. We had Darren Ron, Brian
there.
Simpson, yeah. Chuck Loeb.
Of course, Paul yeah. Brown was
Paul
there.
Paul Brown.
Mm-hmm. That's crazy.
Paul Hardcastle Jr.
Oh, yeah.
Love him.
It was, yeah. And Jay Lee.
Oh, yeah. Jay
it was
Lee.
Such a fun show.
It was cool.
I mean, that was such a fun trip. I had such a good time. I felt like I left with just a whole new group of friends and family. Mm-hmm.
Sure.
You know,
yeah,
a lot
it was
of
cool.
really cool people. So let's talk about your music here. I want to play this first song called Easy Does It.
Okay.
So let's talk about that one.
Okay, so this was like this was the first single of mine from that So Many Ways CD back in 2006. And it was funny because it was never my choice to be a single. I kind of, you know, I presented the album to them and they said, okay, we're gonna pick something. And I think they played a few things to Alan Kepler, and I think they played a couple of things, and Dave Kunert was involved back then as well. And they decided to go with the ballad, and I was like, are you sure? You know, because I don't know. I mean, I didn't have any experience of putting out records and putting out singles. But they said, no, this is the one for us. Okay, cool. And it actually it's got a bass solo in it, you know. And this was like, this is my first single. It's got a bass solo in it. I mean, you know, nothing against bass solos.
Where's the piano solo?
But it so happened that the bass solo was a fantastic bass solo by a guy called Julian Crampton in the UK, who's like one of the best bass players, I think, in the world. And it was my first single, and it did pretty well. I can't really remember, but it sort of got my foot in the door. You know, it was a kind of I think it was like a top 15 Billboard single, and that's the story.
Yes. All right. Well, let's check it out. This is Easy Does It by our in studio guest, Mr. Ali Silk, right here on Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio. I was vibing to this the other night.
Oh, cool.
Oh, yeah.
It features my good buddy Matt Park on the guitar, if I remember right.
Did Paul do any producing with you, or...?
No, I don't know, over the years. No, we had a dialogue. He was really good to me. He was doing his radio show with Alan. And he championed all that stuff. I don't think I ever met Paul. I invited him down lots of times to the shows, but I haven't seen Paul Jr. for a long time either.
No?
But I know he's busy. I think he's cutting a record at the moment.
Oh, good. Good. I really like this. memories for you?
Yeah, I never listened to it. In fact, I'm just thinking now that I've been playing it wrong.
You've been playing it wrong for quite a long time. That's funny. Like, wait a minute, that wasn't the note that... got that vibe, that groove that just
the hook was
pulls
strong.
You in.
Yeah.
Yes, yes, absolutely. I mean, how can you not like the song? And from the get-go, the right away the sounds
great
are coming
vibe.
In and everything.
Yeah.
It's just,
oh, I appreciate that.
No,
thanks, guys.
Very, very nice. That was Easy Does It by our in-studio guest, Mr. Ollie Silk, off of his very first album.
First solo record, yeah, so many ways.
And is it still available? Is it still
sure,
in production?
Yeah, they're all there, iTunes and everything. I did have a store on my website, but I had to take that down because it was just because I had all the stock in the UK. Mm-hmm. It was getting so expensive to send
to ship
to the US.
Yeah,
so
when I have to ship to the UK, it's very expensive.
It is. So unfortunately, I had to knock that on the head. But yeah, it's available at all the usual online retailers.
Well, there you go. What is your website?
Website is www.olliesilk.com. But that's kind of, I just kind of use that really just to put up gigs now.
Mm-hmm. So that's what I was going to say. So they can find out where you're going to be
and I try and
news
keep that
up about
to date
you.
Where possible. And there's a biog on there and some stuff. But once I get back from this trip, I've got some more to put up there. So
do you find that you use your social media more than your web page? I have to always remember to update my website because I do so much on social media that I'm like, oops, I need to update the website.
Yeah,
too.
I'm bad. I get told off all the time for it. Yeah. I'm really bad at doing it.
So what are you working on these days today? I just finished
an album. I just sent it. It's just being mastered this weekend.
Nice. When is it going to be released?
That'll be released, I think, on July 1st or 2nd or something. Somewhere around there.
Excellent. Nice summer release.
Yeah. So it's all just, hot off the press right now. I've just okayed all the covers and the artwork and things. So yeah, I'm excited. It's cool. It's like 2.5 years in the making. I take a while, but
that's okay.
Yeah,
that's okay.
So like before I came out here, it was just a frantic kind of 4 or 5 weeks of finishing and mixing and stuff because I just knew I wanted to get it done before I came out, just to hit that deadline, it's got Peter White, Rick Braun, Alfie Rene, Nick Colione, Phil Denny's on there. Steve Cole is on there. Can't forget Steve.
Nice.
So yeah, it's nice. Got some buddies on there.
Yeah. Wow. And the name of this is called?
It's called Where I Left Off.
Where I Left Off.
Mm-hmm. I have a question. Do you record on an acoustic piano for your records? Do you have a piano at your studio?
I don't have a piano at my studio. I record at a great studio called East Coast Studios, which is in West London, randomly. Yeah, East Coast Studios in West London. And I record on the piano that was played for Adele's Rolling in the Deep. It's that piano.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
wow.
So
wow.
Nice.
You
fancy.
Yeah, I know.
Excuse me.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's a nice Yamaha.
C7?
Yeah, C7.
My favorite piano.
Yeah, yeah. Great,
when
they're
good.
Great for this music.
Yeah, right.
Really biting, nice attack.
Yeah.
And we had a nice pair of U87s on there. And yeah, it was lovely.
Good.
Yeah.
Very, very nice. So the next song that I want to play, it's got parentheses, the La La song, but it's called I'm In Pieces.
I'm In Pieces, yeah.
So Oh.
Yeah, you got
I'm
it now.
I'm just so, you know, I'm just so slow sometimes. Yet last show, there was one that was called, I was pronouncing it wrong,
okay.
You know, and I was saying funk shui, and that's how it was, but it was funk shui.
I'm like, oh, duh,
right. You know, funk stupid shui. Me. And so again, stupid me. I'm a little slow in the morning.
Pieces. it kind of looks weird when it's written down. It's okay.
I was just
it's
like,
just
okay, I'm trying to get it, but. You have to say it out loud.
I'm in pieces. Yes.
And I never said it out loud to myself. So,
yeah.
So let's talk about.
So this tune, we're going to play this tonight, actually. We're going to open the show with this tonight. And it will be only the second time I've ever played it live. I kind of worked it up before I came out because I really wanted to play it for a long, long time. But I never worked the chart up for the band and stuff. Mm. So yeah, we're going to do it tonight. I'm excited. What can I say about the record? It's got Oscar Seton Jr. on drums. Yes. It's got Smitty Smith on the bass. Mm. Smitty.
Uncle Smitty. Smitty.
It's got Mark James on guitar.
Nice.
It's a real nice, uplifting, happy jam, and I'm glad that I'm going to start opening my shows with it because it's really cool.
Oh, nice. Did you opening song, huh?
Did you record Long Distance with them, or did you come
I
over
did,
here?
Yeah. Oscar and Smitty have been on the records now. This is their fourth record
right.
They've recorded on. We've done it in various studios, but it's always been in L.A. Mm-hmm. We did Dennis Moody, you know Dennis?
Mm-hmm.
We did one. Mm-hmm. We did a session at his. That was the first one, and I actually came over for that session because it was on New Year's, and I had a gig. And that's the first time I met Oscar, and I played with Smitty a few times by then. And then, where did they record? A guy called Barry Paul's place. You know, Barry Paul is like a really crazy, eccentric English guy. You know Barry, right? And he wears really short shorts.
Super British. Short shorts.
This guy, I mean,
introduce
he's like,
me.
he ain't a spring chicken, but like, yeah. You know, he was quite fit for his age,
yeah.
You know. But yeah, that was a weird session because like the shorts were
distracting.
Yeah, they were.
Yeah.
And you know, Smitty's man of few words, two or three hours into the session, it was all quite serious because we were recording. He was just like, Barry, man, those shorts, man, they're killing the vibe.
I'll never forget it. It cracked me up.
Good old Uncle Smitty. That is something he would say.
Oh, that is hilarious.
So we cut there, and then more recently they've been cutting at Gordon Campbell's place.
Gordon.
And he's got a monster drum sound.
Nice.
So.
I love Gordon.
Yeah.
I haven't seen him in so long.
Okay.
Yeah,
And so on the latest record, we got I got Oscar to play a few, but Gordon also played some, and also Amari Williams played some because
of Amari.
I used him on my first CD release party for this
so
last
good.
Album.
Yeah.
I love him.
He's got
what a
great
sweetheart. He's so
pocket.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. He made things sound so good for my release.
And
I mean,
he's
he just.
Too. Just put that out there.
Oh, yeah, yeah. He's
okay.
He's easy to work with, too. So
I thought you were
going to
say he's so easy on the eye.
Right.
Well,
yeah, she says that too.
He's so easy to work with.
Sure.
I mean, I gave him some challenges, and he was like, with a smile, no problem, you know?
Yeah. Because I had met him when Boney came over a couple of years ago and we played. He didn't bring keyboards or bass, so I got my guy, Orofo, to play bass. And that was great. I think Boney was really nervous because he'd never kind of played with a half-hired band before.
Right.
It went really, really well. And yeah, I was just sitting there. All I was doing was listening to Amari play.
Right.
Yeah. I was, you know.
Yeah, I love Amari. He's wonderful. All right, well, let's play I'm in Pieces. Peace is. The La La song. All right. You're listening to Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio.
You worked it up, now you're going to work it out.
Sorry to put you on the spot.
It's Eric Valentine.
Yeah.
Right. Eric's the one that introduced me to Amari. Because Eric was supposed to play on that gig. And he couldn't make it. So he says, I got someone for you.
Good call. Great choice.
Like,
yeah.
I said hi.
I will.
Yes.
You know what? I think that is a girl called Paula Crawford. She actually sang on the Sugar and Silk. But I've known her since college. It's like,
oh, wow.
Yeah. I think she sang that. Yeah. It sounds like her.
But tonight, it's going to be singing Diva.
Flower in her hair.
Wow,
oh no, no, it looks good. You look marvelous.
Thanks.
I love watching you perform live. Got that energy.
Not having a bass solo. You threw me.
Do you normally stand when you play?
Yeah. I didn't used to, but again, I got told off.
Oh.
Because it wasn't dynamic. I prefer to play sitting down. I can play bass.
You play great standing up.
Because I can kind of dance around. I have a guitar.
Right, so as I said, the energy you have when you play is,
yeah,
I love it. This is from the
Great Sharp Brits in the last 2013.
Right.
13, yeah, 13.
I remember reading that. Love it. I'm in pieces.
I feel bad I'm not going tonight.
Oh, I know. It's going to be a great show.
We'll miss you, man.
I'm hoping I can make it there.
You can see the twerk
and
all that.
Yes.
Yep.
Yep.
I'm actually really excited to come hear you tonight.
Oh, I can't wait. It's going to be cool. I think we have a sellout now. So that's nice.
Because I was trying to get tickets. Like, I got 6 tickets already, and I was trying to get some more. And they were like, yeah, girl, sorry. I didn't even get a chance to promote it good because the tickets were sold out before I could really get going.
Well, it's not every day that you get Ollie Silk coming to the U.S., you know?
Yeah.
So,
yeah, it's a big deal. Kind of a big deal.
It is.
I mean, you're kind of a big deal.
Kind of.
Stop it.
It's true.
Keep it going. Stop it.
Yeah, yeah.
Stop.
Oh, my gosh. So, are you going to be playing music from just the new CD? Are you gonna be playing stuff from all?
Well,
of your
we're gonna do. I worked up a little preview. Again, it'll be the first time we ever play it. Which is the cover version that's on the record is "Burning Up the Carnival" by Joe Sample. And so I worked that up before I left. So we're gonna do that, aren't we? Yeah, we're gonna do "Burning Up the Carnival" tonight. But no, I'm gonna be playing. I think I've pretty much done a set that's got something from each record.
Nice.
I like to do that.
Nice.
And we've got a couple of fun things in there as well. A couple of cover tunes, and it's gonna be cool. It's
Yay.
Gonna be cool. And I'm gonna do my vocoder-y singy thing at some point.
Good.
I hope.
Oh, love it.
Yeah.
Man, I wish you were going to be here in June because I have my show there.
Really?
I have
cool.
10 piece band. Well, I have 3 background vocals. There's not going to be any stems. It's going to be, I have 2 keyboard, percussion, trumpet, sax, flute. Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know where I'm going to fit them all, but we're going to squeeze in there somehow. But
yeah,
it's going to be so much fun. I'm going to do songs from the the different albums that I have, mm-hmm. and then some fun covers, and
oh, great.
Then bring some people up just to have
yeah
fun.
Yeah, mm-hmm. well, if you're around June 25th, please come on in
and tell everybody where it's at.
Spagatini Seal Beach. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying.
That's the place.
Yes. So, okay, let me see here. I can't read the song titles, and I don't want to get them wrong. So here we go. Oh, At Your Service, featuring Julian Vaughn. I get to play with him for the first time when I go to Nashville. I'm hosting. I'm the host.
Oh.
Can you believe I'm a host
awesome.
Of the Music City Jazz Festival this
International.
Year.
International.
I believe that.
In Nashville.
Amazing.
That's
good
fantastic.
I can't even believe it. And then I'm playing with Kim Scott's Block Party with featuring myself and Julian Vaughn.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
And so I get to play with Julian and... I can't wait.
It's
really
been a
really
long time.
To it.
I haven't seen Julian for maybe since Dubai, I guess.
Wow.
But, I don't know. Maybe I saw him once since then. But yeah, he's cool. Cool cat. Great sound.
So let's talk about this song that he's on with you.
Yeah. I mean, it again, a bit like yourself with Darren, it kind of came about just by being in Dubai with him. And
Dubai's the place to
be,
huh?
Yeah. And we discussed it. And I said, look, man, we've got to do a track together somehow. And he was like, okay, well, you know. Work something up for me, and I'll see what we can do. And he loved it, so.
Isn't he on Trippin' and Rhythm?
Yeah,
I thought. Okay, that's what I thought.
So same label, and it's always easier when it's same label, you know. You can get permissions for singles mm-hmm. and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So yeah, and I didn't actually, I wasn't sort of presuming that it was going to be the lead-off single for the record, but it just has such a kind of immediate feel, and again, it's upbeat and pretty cool. And there we go again. So we have more bass.
More bass solo.
More bass.
Terry, you got your wish.
Good. Back in my comfort zone.
back in Terry's comfort zone. There's plenty of bass in here for you, Terry. So.
Oh, all right. Well, let's check this out. This is At Your Service and featuring Julian Vaughn.
All right.
On bass with our in-studio guest, Mr. Ollie Silk, right here on Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio.
Terry, you and I need to go to Dubai and come back making hits.
Place to go to make a hit. Thank you.
It's my favorite bit.
I like that.
They didn't like that very much. I had to cut that.
They
bit.
Didn't? No, no, not for
I,
the radio.
I had that. I had that going.
Oh, at the end.
Yeah.
So
they were like, no.
So can I say how great your album sound? You know, that I really love. I've always loved your playing and your writing, but the production
is clean.
It's very cool. It's very. I really, really dig it.
Yeah, I mean, I'm like you. I sort of slave over the mix.
Right.
You
yeah,
know?
You can tell.
And mixing is a tough beast. Yeah. You know, it's not like any other part of the process. Mm-hmm. And when you've lived with your music for so long, it's difficult to keep.
And it can kill sort of an amazing song.
What you're doing, you
right.
know.
It can kill a song if you don't get it right.
Definitely, yeah. You know, and I'll hold my hands up and say that I think, you know, some of my early stuff, you know, I could have done better with that, you know, and it's a shame. So every time I kind of knuckle down and I think, right, I'm going to try and make this better than the last one, you know. Well, and I'm always reading
job.
About mixing. It's so boring, you know. Like I've got loads of books and I sit on the plane and kind of just read.
But it's such an important part of what we do as artists now. Mm-hmm. All
yeah,
of us.
Yeah.
Too.
The sound is really important.
Yeah, and you generally, nowadays, you have to pretty much do everything yourself unless you have a big budget, you know.
Nobody does.
Who has one?
So only because we're running short on time and
sure.
I want to make sure I get the live performance. How long are your live performances so I know how much time? Because we may have to fade this last song before you play.
I think they're both like 4 minutes long.
Okay, so
I think actually all we need may be slightly shorter than 4 minutes.
Okay.
I think Didn't Know About Love maybe like 4.5. Mm.
So I'm going to play Get It Together.
Yeah, you want to hear me some vocoder, so.
Yeah. And then we're going to get right into you guys doing a little live.
Okay.
How's that sound?
Yeah, cool.
All right, so this is Get It Together off of which?
This is from The Limits of the Sky. This is right back in 2008, second CD, so.
Okay, all right. Mr. Ali Silk, right here on Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio. And don't go anywhere because up next is the live.
It'll be hot.
Roll.
don't forget to go there with what I'm trying to say. Everybody's don't forget to go there with what I'm trying to say.
You can put this in your tongue.
Everybody's don't forget to go there with what I'm trying to say. Everybody's got to get it today, but that's what I'm trying to say. Everybody's got to get it today, but that's what I'm trying to say.
Is this an okay place to start fading it? Is it okay? Okay. We'll fade this out. I know, I'm having fun with the song, but I don't want to mess up the live part. Very cool. I love this.
It's
a fun
tune.
It is.
It kind of, it only dawned on me like last week, this, it kind of a bit like Hard Work, you know that song? Is that by John Hurley, Hard Work?
Oh, yeah, that yeah. Uh-huh.
Thing.
I love it.
Right, what are we doing then, band? What are we going to
do? So, which one do you want to do first? We got...
Let's do all we need first.
All we need first?
The grand finale.
Mm-hmm. The grand.
You got it. Let me get this one finale. Stopped. Nope, we didn't stop it.
Take my juju back.
Okay.
You did this yourself.
Obviously. Yeah.
So we're gonna do which one?
I stained it.
All we need. I think.
All we need. Yeah. All right. So live to you from Smooth Saturdays with Aysha on LA Talk Radio, Mr. Ollie Silk. All we need. Thank you.
fingers are hurting.
We have 5 minutes left, just enough time to play this last song.
Okay.
So this is called
Didn't Know About Love Until I Found You.
This is funny. I never sing this inning, so okay.
Okay, well, here we go. Let's do this. This is going to be fun.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. my goodness. What a way to end the show. Thank you so much for tuning in. You're listening
to
Smooth
Saturdays
with Aysha on LA Talk Radio. Ollie Silk. Shannon Pearson on vocals. And you guys.
And Terry Wolllman.
And Terry Wolllman on guitar. If you guys are in town this evening, you need to go to Spaghettini and Seal Beach and see this show, because you're going to see these guys do their thing live. Shannon, please leave.
So I am Sangandiva, S-A-N-G-I-N-D-I-V-A, everywhere. Sangandiva.com, Sangandiva on Instagram, on Snapchat. Hey, Snapchat friends, Twitter, every Facebook, everywhere you can find me, and I will see you.
You're going to Japan?
I am. I'm on my way to Japan.
I'm so
leaving.
Sorry that we have to end the show.
But we'll, I'll come back. I'll come back. Okay.
Yes, please.
Love you guys.
Thank you so much for being on the show. We
great
love
job.
You.
You've
please, been every first Saturdays and Aysha third Saturday of
LA
every
Talk
month.
Radio.
Make sure
to tune
in.
Next
every
time.
First and third Saturday from 10 a.m.
Wonderful
to
show.
PM.
Thank you.
Thank you, Terry Wolllman. Shannon Pearson. Ollie Silk.
Thank you, Aysha.
What a